In this shoemaking tutorial, I'm gonna talk with you about different leather types that I use for uppers in making my shoes. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and make sure to click the bell button to know when my new video will come out. So there are a lot of different types of leather, and today I will show you what I use, how to work with them. I will explain main steps that you will need to follow if you will want to use same types of leather in making your shoes. So let's start. Learn how to make shoes with my step-by-step video course. One of my favorite leather types that I use recently in making my shoes is suede. It's very beautiful leather in my opinion. It has many different colors, but it's very difficult to work with because it's very difficult to clean it, especially if you will work with the bright shades of the colors. For example, you see I have now this kind of light gray, or for example this camel color, to also very bright. So during your work you should keep it very clean, and it's very difficult because shoemaking it's not so clean craft. So what I advise you is to clean your clean the place where you work. Always work with clean hands, because each small touch will leave some kind of mark, dirty mark on the sweat, and it will be very difficult to clean. Especially it's very difficult to clean spots of glue, contact glue. So during working with these types of leather like suede, you should be very accurate and keep your hands clean, and place glue apart from your working place. Okay, this is first thing. Next thing is that there are different thicknesses of suede leather, and it can be made from different animal hides. I prefer to work with goat skin. It comes with small dimensions, like you will see right now. It's full leather and full skin, and it's the range of this dimension is between 4 and 5 feet, and it's enough, I think, for simple flats. For example, it's enough for 2.5 pairs. Okay, it's of course depend on size, and it depend on the style of your flat white shoes. If you have many different details, maybe it will not enough for 2.5 pairs. But if you make simple classic flat body shoes or Oxford shoes, it will be enough for 2.5 pairs. So first thing that I already mentioned is during your work you should keep your working place very clean. Second thing, this leather and for women's shoes, the thickness of this leather must be not more than 1 millimeter and not less, because if it will be very thin, even if you will reinforce it, during lasting it may tear up. So ideal thickness of this type of leather, suede leather, is 1 millimeter. Now it's still very soft leather. You see, it's very soft. So in some places, like for example, if you make boots, in some places you will still to reinforce it. But for example, the shoes I made many years ago, but it's better to reinforce entire shoe. For example, in boots, or you know, in even in a simple flats. It's not simple, but here is a part of the upper where I made it from sweat. You see, I still need to reinforce it so it will keep the shape of the shoe. It's actually one of my newest prototypes that I made, that soon you will see my new shoes in my upcoming renovated website, where it will be available for sale. Okay, now, so we should reinforce it, and there are special reinforcement fabric canvas that we use in shoemaking. See, this is one. It has adhesive side, and to attach it to the upper, you should take off this paper on the adhesive side, and also you need to use iron to activate the glue of this canvas better. But if you don't have this kind of canvas, you can use, and now I will show you how it looks. You see, so it will keep the shape of the upper, it will stay with beautiful shape with this reinforcement. So if you don't have this one, this material, this canvas, you can use ordinary canvas fabric that we use in making clothes when we want to reinforce it, and it activates with iron. So you can use this fabric too if you will want to work with sweat. So make sure to keep your working place clean hands, reinforce sweat with fabric or canvas, special fabric that we use in making clothes, same one, and you can activate it with iron. Now, another thing that you can also keep in your mind during assembling different parts of your upper made from sweat, you can skive on the inner side of this leather. For example, in the places where we have underlying, we usually need to skive on the top surface of our leather. Why? Because then we will skive this area until the mark to create this scratches of to reduce the thickness of leather, and also to make this surface a little bit scratchy, so it will be very you will attach two pieces together better when the surface will be scratched. That's why we skive in the places where we have underlined, for example. But sweat leather is already has this scratchy surface, surface. So that's why it would be better if you will skive the places where you will attach the second part of your upper. In the places where you have underline, skive on the inner side of your sweat. Why? Because usually top side of leather stronger. So this leather is very soft. So to keep these places strong and stable, where we need to attach two places one with another, it will be better if you will keep this area with the same strength that leather already has. So it's better, that's why it's better to skive on the inner side of the sweat leather. Okay? Now, if you made a mistake, for example, and get dirty in some place of your upper, get dirty your sweat leather in some place in making uppers, You can clean it with this erasable material. It's crap. It's made from caoutchouc resin. For example, it erases marks left from this silver pen that we use in making shoes. For example, you see, if I will have this mark, let's make here this mark. You see, we can erase it with this material, with this crap. If you will have some spots left from glue, you can clean it with, you can try to clean it with this brush with the metal pins, but remember that it may be very, very careful, because working with this brush, you remove thin layer of sweat. You see, when I will clean it, small pieces of leather left on this brush. So for example, you made a shoe with bright colors like this boot that I made. For example, you see here it's scratched a little bit because here was some spot of glue that I cleaned with this brush, and you see it removed a little bit it removed thin layer of sweat, and that's why you may see the difference on the surface between this place and all other places of the upper. Okay, so you can clean it, but very carefully. And also, you may have some spots of glue here in the place where you attach the leather sole. So also here, working with the this brush, very accurately you can clean it. If not, nothing will help you with this, so this is one of the options. Now, after you will finish working on your shoes, you can remove all dust left on the upper with simple sponge. It will remove dust perfectly. So clean it everywhere and place it in some nylon bag to protect it from other dust that you have in your working environment. Now, when I make my shoes from this material, from this leather, sweat leather, I love to be sure about cleaning, so I also use, just a minute, these two sprays. It's not the their name of the brand doesn't important. What's important is that one of them is spray to clean from dust. So after you cleaned with the sponge your upper from dust, use the spray to clean it even better. Then also work with the brush a little bit, and then I use this spray that will protect the sweat from moisture. Okay, from water. So I use this also, and then if some spots of water will if you will, I don't know, rain or something else, some accident with water, it will not go through the sweat, it will stay on the surface, and you can brush it off and it will stay dry. Now, in this boot that I made, you see, in this part of the boot, I didn't place any reinforcement here because I thought that here it's not important. And you can see the difference between this part of the shoe and this part of the shoe where we have reinforcement. It keeps the shape, and here it lays how it lays. Okay. But here in this place where we want to keep the shape, original shape, the shape of our shoe last, you should use reinforcement fabric canvases, or the professional one, or the simple, this one, to reinforce this sweat leather. Okay. Now, also one important moment. If during sewing you made a mistake, working with sewed leather, it's easy to fix it, because when you will work with sweat, holes left from awl, well, not from awl, from needle, you will be able to remove it working with hammer. So if you made a mistake, for example, you will see, I will make here hole. Let's pretend that this is hole from left from needle. It's a little bigger than the needle, but you will see how it will disappear when you will hit with hammer. Okay, so this is one of the benefits working with sweat leather. It has benefits and disadvantages, but this is one of them. Disadvantage is to, it's hard to clean it, so keep it very clean. And that's why maybe it's better in the beginning, if you want to try working with sweat leather, it's better to use black sweat, because here, if you made a mistake in lasting process, you can color it a little bit with spray. There are sprays with color, and it's usually black color. So with the spray, you can color it, and it will not be. You will not see any mistake here. It will be colored with this spray. Okay, and so that's why maybe if you want to start working with this type of leather, start with the black color, okay? Like I did here in this boot. Also last thing, it's a thread. If you will work with bright colors like this one, camel, or any other shade of beige, camel, etc., you can work with one color of thread. This one, it's kind of beige thread, because you will not distinguish between the color of thread and leather, because it will stay like inside of the upper, and it will not you will not see that the thread has different color than the leather has, because it has this kind of soft surface, and the thread stay deep inside of the surface. So that's why maybe when you will work with bright colors of sweat, you can work with one color of thread, okay? One color, bright colors of sweat and beige color of thread. If you will start from black sweat, you have black thread, and it will work fine here. Okay, so that's it regarding sweat leather. So it is the goat skin or sheep skin. It also can be calf skin, baby calf skin, and it must be with a thickness of 1 millimeter. Second type of leather that I work with is patent leather. You should understand that this first two types that I mentioned, sweat leather and patent, and I will talk about it in a few minutes, they are these types of leather required a little bit experience. So that's why maybe if you are a total beginner, wait a little bit, start with all other types of leather, and I will talk about them too in the end of this tutorial. And then only after you have some experience in shoemaking, you can start working with these types of leather, because there are a lot of many small things inside of work with these leather types, okay? It's not only these things that I mentioned, there are much more that you will discover during your work. So it's better, if you're a total beginner, maybe it's better to start with simple types of leather, and I will talk about them later, okay? So patent leather. I like this leather because of its bright qualities. It's, you see how it reflects the light. And I use it, for example, in this shoe that I made. And I love to work with pattern in this design because it emphasizes the shape of the shoe last. It has different curves here that I want to emphasize to create this direct view. So everybody will see the shapes immediately because of this patterned leather. Also, when you work with patterned leather and create not a lot of parts like I use here, you see it's only one cut here and another small part of the quarters, you can play with stitches to emphasize different moments like I did here. You see here I have double stitch and here one stitch. Maybe you can't see it immediately, but you distinguish between these two parts, even if it looks if it made from one color, from one type of leather. So there are a lot of different design approach, technique approach that you can use to upgrade your shoe, to upgrade design of your shoe, like I did here in this shoe. It's Oxford shoe. Now, so let's start with patterned leather. I have here a few examples, and actually it's difficult to work with patterned leather in elastic process because usually this type of leather is very stiff, and it can be crucial working with this leather during lasting. You see, it's like some cardboard. You see, even if I place here, even if I moisture it a little bit to soften it, it still will stay very stable, and it's very difficult to last pointed toe shoes here because it will have here many folds, and it's very difficult to avoid elimination, to avoid creation of these folds. That's why when you choose patterned leather, first thing that you should to choose is the softness of the patterned leather. This, for example, is excellent material, but it doesn't suit for closed shoes, for pump shoes, for Oxford shoes, or any other closed shoes, because it's very stiff. Maybe some part inside of the upper, but because it's too stiff and too thickness, it's the first thing, it will be very difficult to last it without folds. But we don't want to have folds in our shoes. We want to have beautiful toe without any folds. So that's why the thickness of leather, patterned leather, must be not more than 1 millimeter, and even a little bit thinner, like 0.9. Okay. Also, when you choose patterned leather, you should try to fold it a little bit to feel how it feels in your hands. You see, this, for example, is very soft. It's not too soft that can tear up during plastic. It's also one of the most common situations that can happen during plastic, your uppers made from patterned. But it's not too soft and not too hard. You see, for example, the difference between this pattern and this pattern. I can't scratch it more, not scramble it more, but this one I can, you see? And when I open it, return to its place, nothing, you will not see here any lines. It will not breaks. So that means that this leather pattern is good one. And this one also good material, but I will use this for sandals, for example, because sandals making we have straps, and straps made from this very stiff patterned leather, but with good quality, will keep the shape of our sandals and will look great. Okay, so thickness is 1 millimeter or even 0.9. Now, also you should reinforce it. Reinforce your upper with same canvases like this one or this one with iron. You can work with iron, but not, don't keep it too much before you will go to work with pattern and reinforcement from fabric. Check small piece with iron how it works with the with heart of iron. Okay, so reinforce it, but that don't reinforce this part of the upper, because when reinforce only back part. Why? Because here when we last our upper, we last first lining, then we place toe puff, and during the this entire process our upper lace turn over, and with the time when you will pull it back, because of the fabric that we attach here, it will have here folds, some kind of lines that you will not be able to erase. It will not disappear even during lasting. And if you will last too much with your pincers, you will tear up the pattern. Okay, so reinforce only middle part of your upper. Don't reinforce the toe puff and the toe part of the upper. Now, it's a great material. Again, it also can tear up during lasting if you will stretch it too much. So how much you need to stretch, I can't tell you. You need to feel it during work. So please don't start with strong pulling. Try step by step pull it and see how it stretches. If you see that it already stretched too much, stop it and attach it. It's enough. Don't stretch too much because you tear up your button leather. Here is another example of button leather. You see it has this kind of washed effect, and also great button to work with. But during lasting, this will a little disappear, this effect, and will stay mostly on the sides of the upper, and here it will be more cleaned without this effect, without this washed effect. Okay, now in sewing it's very difficult to erase holes left from needle, because with the with the hammer it will be very difficult to erase, because this is the quality of this material. So be very precise in sewing and use thin thread, not thread, thin needle, like number 19 or 100, not 90 100. Okay, so the holes will be not too big, and it's also very important to create beautiful upper working with this material, because it's beautiful by itself, and with the stitches you can to emphasize the beauty of the material, like I said before, with the double stitches. But what is important is the length of the stitches. It doesn't be too big and not too straight, because it will tear up here in these places, because it's too many holes in one spot. So ideal length of the stitches is approximately 1.5 millimeters, maybe 2 millimeters. Okay, this is ideal step of the stitch. Okay, so that's it for the patent leather. Next type of leather is printed leather. I personally love to work with the print, like reptiles skin, like this one is crocodile, kind of crocodile skin. You see, and it's mostly made on calf skin. So these pieces of leather comes in big dimensions. It must be also not too thick. The thickness is about 1 millimeter, 1 millimeter point one. What is the main thing that you need to remember working with printed leather? Is how to place your uppers during cutting, because you want to have identical halves. You want that the pattern that you have on the skin will be the same on both halves. So that's why maybe if you will work with printed leather, you will have a lot of waste, because you should place your upper leg, take this one, identically. So the pattern on one half will be the same as on the second half. Okay, so this is one of the most important things. So for example, you see here I have different pattern, and I will place it. For example, you see here, and it's here, it looks identically. So I will place my upper one half here and second half here. So in the middle will be a waste of material, and maybe if you make shoes for yourself, it's okay, you can use the small pieces in some other projects. In my case, it will be a lot of waste, because in mass production all these parts will go away. So keep it in mind, it's very important to know how to work with printed leather. But I know that there are a lot of waste here, but I love this crocodile print that I use here in my shoe. I thought that it will be very interesting combination between printed leather here and patterned leather in front of the shoe. Okay, you see here, for example, I also reinforced it, and I will talk about it later. In this area, you see, it keep the shape of the shoe, and here it without reinforcement, because when I will wear it will be very soft. I will show you, and it will lay on my feet like this, creating kind of twisted effect here. Okay, so that's why here I didn't reinforce other part of the upper. So you know, it's very important to know these technical moments and use it according to the design of your shoes. So you can reinforce it in the places where you want. I will reinforce it definitely in this part of the upper. If you make pumps shoes, Oxford shoes, reinforce entire upper with same reinforcement materials, fabrics, canvases like this one or this one. Okay, and skiving. Usually printed leather, it's some kind of leather that had a lot, the hide of this animal had a lot of scratches, had a lot of marks, and that's why to use it, to sell this leather, they use it for printed leather to hide the scratches, to hide these marks. Okay, so they sometimes scratch the entire surface and use many different finishing process. Let's don't go deep in it. But what is important in skiving, it's same thing with the sweat. Skive in the places where you have underlined, like this one. Skive inner side, skive from the inner side of the leather to keep this part of our upper strong. Okay. So this is printed leather. There is also printed leather with a patterned printed leather, and in this type of leather use both approaches that I mentioned here for patterned leather and for printed leather. Mix them together and you will have kind of general idea how to work with printed patterned leather. Next leather type is crust leather. vegetable tanned leather. I use sheepskin, this one. It's excellent, brilliant material. I love to work with. It's very soft. You can create here many different effects after finishing the shoe. And main idea to work with crust leather, vegetable tanned leather, is that you have here any possibilities. You can choose the color that you want. If you don't have any color, can buy the specific color of leather, you can color it by yourself. This is how I work. For example, I have this crust leather and I have sweat with color, with dark blue color, and I want to create leather that will suit to this color. And I did it in this shoe. This one of my newest shoes that I made, and you see it first, and it will be available to purchase on my website soon. So here you see, I colored this upper, it was like this, and I created color that will that suits for the front part of the shoe, for the dark blue sweat. You see, here it was like this one. So you here you have this great opportunity to design whatever you want, to create any color. What color, what type of dye I use here? Let's make it very clean. Also working with this type of leather, keep your working place clean, especially when you work with colors and mix between them, place it apart to not get it dirty. Okay, so for example, I have here two colors, basic colors, red and blue, and mixing these two colors, I created this new color, like purple, kind of purple color. So this is a color based on alcohol. It penetrates deeply inside of the leather and stay forever. And what is important working with this dyes is that you can have few of them, principal basic colors, mix between them and create different colors. So you need to have red, blue, yellow, and green, and black, of course, because black you will not create. So this, how much you want to run through, five colors, five dyes, it's enough to create many different colors. Then after you finish to work with, you can leave it like it is now. It has matte surface, it's not shiny, but when you will shine it with brushes, with rags, working with beeswax, it will be very shiny. Like you see, like here, it has this effect of reflected light. Okay, it's very shiny, and in the same way, it protects leather, because if you will not use any cream, any beeswax, the surface stay open, like our pores. The pores are opened, so any mark, like even water, can leave a spot. So it's better to protect it with transparent beeswax or with creams like this one, for example. You see, you can use creams that will suits for the color of your leather. For example, if you made red color, use cream with red color. Okay, this is most important things regarding working with vegetable tanned leather. The thickness is same, 1 millimeter, not too much. Don't use here too thick leather for woman shoes, and not too thin, because it may tear up. I will show you an example. This one, for example, you see here, it's very soft, very beautiful leather, but for garment, not for shoes, because it's too thin. You see, I can tear up and eat. I just pull it and it tear up, you see? So maybe for bags it's okay, but not for shoes. Okay, so the thickness is important. 1 millimeter is optimal thicknesses, thickness for women's shoes. Okay, it's vegetable tanned leather. Now let's talk about all other different types of leather that I advise to work with if you're a total beginner. Because patterned leather, sweat leather, as I mentioned, required a lot of experience or some kind of experience. But working with this simple, let's say simple types of leather is definitely your first option to work with if you are total beginner in shoemaking. So what are those simple, as I call it, types of leather? It's Napa leather. It's excellent type of leather with full grain. The full grain meaning that the top, so here we use only top surface of leather. It's not the second one, it's not split leather and not second layer of the skin. It's the first top full top layer of leather. And it can be goat skin, sheep skin, calf skin. Okay, this is the hides of animals that we use for leather in making shoes. There are a lot of other, but this is the main, this is the basic, let's say basic types of leather. Now, it is without any print and it has a bright and clean surface like this one. You see, this is calf skin, and thickness of this leather is 1 millimeter. And from this type of leather, you see, I made this shoe. It's very the full grain. It's excellent leather because in the same it will keep not keep. It is strong enough, and in the same time it's soft. So for example, you see, I used here this element. I created here folding. I created here many folds, and because of quality of this leather, Napa skin, full grain skin, I could create here this folds that you can see, you can feel them, they are exist. Okay, so, and in the same time it's very soft and it's solid leather. And working with Napa leather, with full grain leather, you can not reinforce it. For example, with the canvases that I showed you, you can reinforce it, or you, if you decide to not reinforce it, you can do it without any reinforcement. Okay, so there are a lot of colors. Here I used black and white, but there are different colors, like I showed you here, what you see here in this boot that I made. I used also, this is goat skin, this is calf skin, but also goat skin with full grain black one, and for lining I used the red. Okay, red one. It's the boot like this, you see, asymmetrical design, and the thickness is 1 millimeter, 1 millimeter point 1. It's enough for women's shoes. For men's shoes it can be a little bit thicker. And when you cut your uppers, choose the direction of stretchiness of leather. For example, you see, this one stretches less than if I will stretch it in this direction. So my uppers I will place in the direction where leather stretches less. So each type of leather has different qualities, different stretchiness, and different softness. If it's too soft, reinforce it. It's not soft, don't reinforce it. It's upon your choice, upon the design of your shoes. Now I have a question for you. If you're a beginner and make shoes already, or want to start making shoes, what type of leather you use or will use, maybe you will use some type of leather that I mentioned here. Maybe you want to use some other type of leather that I didn't mention here. So write down in the comment below what type of leather you used or want to use, and I will be happy to see what you're working with. That's it for this tutorial. Thank you for watching. Of course, don't forget to subscribe to this channel, because here I offer a lot of free tutorials about shoemaking. And click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. Thank you for watching. Comment below and see you in the next video. Bye.